When I was 38 years old, my life took a major detour. I felt something that wasn't normal, and within a week and a half, I was diagnosed with cancer. My name is Cindy Stemple. I am the acting SERVIR project manager at NASA Marshall Space Flight Center, and this is my story. It was quite a surprise to me. I did not have any family history of the disease. Not 17 months after the original diagnosis, I was faced with a cancer recurrence. The wind was knocked out of me. This road was a little more difficult to travel the second time around. I have vivid memories of all of my NASA co-workers, their smiles, their tears, their caring words. My NASA co-workers were really part of the hope that pulled me through that difficult period of my life. My role as acting manager of the SERVIR project is to help manage the cost, schedule, and technical aspects of the SERVIR project. SERVIR is a Spanish acronym meaning to serve. We use Earth observation from satellites to aid in environmental decision making in developing countries such as Africa, Southeast Asia, and the Himalayas. I think this project is the culmination of a variety of aspects of my life coming together. It's my love of developing software. It's utilizing my project management background, managing the cost schedule and the technical, but also through the various trials, experiences in my life, the ability to help others brings me so much joy. So I grew up on the Gulf Coast of Mississippi, and we've just experienced the recent Katrina anniversary, and it was a big reminder at how the landscape on the Mississippi Gulf Coast has changed so much. But it is also encouraging to see the growth, to see the new structures, but then also see that the people are the same. They're the same friendly city, the same idyllic small town with which I grew up. The women in my family provided foundational messaging. My mother set the bar high for making a home and caring for her family. And she inspired me to take early summer college preparatory classes. She inspired me to apply for my first job at the National Space Technology Laboratory, which is now the Stennis Space Center. My most rewarding experience at NASA has been in situations where we work as teams. In order for NASA to do the great things we do, it takes bringing together people from all different educational backgrounds and different skill levels and through different work experiences. Interestingly, my work with the Cancer Society helped me greatly in my NASA career as I found myself having to deliver key presentations at test readiness reviews, at design reviews, where my words were giving justification for why we were ready to proceed past a particular NASA key decision point. Some advice that I would give to anyone interested in STEM careers. If you're like me and you're a planner, sometimes the unknown path ahead can be unsettling, but just know that you don't have to see the entire staircase before you take that step. I have learned that when you take that step and you're in that uncomfortable period and your abilities are being stretched, you will grow. See the good qualities in people and tell them you may never know how much one word can influence the life of another. So step forward, take chances, learn, grow, and share.